Okay, just wanted to do a video just talking about what I think is the blatant hypocrisy of this hijab ban over in Quebec. And why I say it's hypocritical is because what it really comes down to, what the premise of it comes down to of is basically they want to ban the secularist, feminist, whatever. They want to ban it because basically they don't like it, and they don't like seeing it, and they don't like it being worn. Well, welcome to the real world, okay? You're gonna see things that you don't like being worn. You just don't get to ban things you don't like seeing, okay? Okay, and by this same argument, I could say, well, guess what? I should be able to ban the bikinis and short shorts because guess what? I don't like seeing that, okay? When I walk down the street in the summer of my town, I don't like, having my eyes assaulted by seeing women dressed like a bunch of whores in these short shorts and going to the beach and seeing them wear these disgusting bikinis. Okay, I don't like seeing that, but do I just get to ban that stuff? I guarantee if I was lobbying for laws to ban that stuff, they would call me some kind of whatever. What are those terms they like using? Misogynistic, patriarchal, whatever, chauvinist. You name it, they're gonna call me that. So wait a second. So again, wait a second. You get to ban the hijab because basically what it comes down to is you don't like it. But wait a second, I can't. If I try to lobby for laws against the sh disgusting short shorts and the filthy bikinis. That's somehow wrong. Okay? Again, you just don't get to ban things because you don't like seeing it. That's just plain and simple. Welcome to the real world, okay? If you don't like seeing it, just deal with it. Seriously. And by the way, too, I've said this before, and this moment makes some people upset. And if you don't like that, you're gonna probably get upset by saying this. If I mean saying this, if you're some kind of liberal feminist out there or whatever. Even some people in the whole counter jihad movement, I've been kind of critical of them for a while too, because they are backing this law. This is going to make some of them upset, but quite frankly, I really couldn't care less. I'd rather live in an area full of hijabis who are modestly dressed than the area I currently live in, where all the women, especially the white women, which is the worst, dress like a bunch of whores. Okay? Watch as the hate comments and the videos about me pour in. But seriously, like, it's more modest that way, and I'd rather be around that. Like, when I go to the beach, the Muslim women, as well as some Hindus too, are the only people who are dressed modestly and are not dressed like a whore and a harlot. I mean, seriously, I'm not even going to go into detail because it's so disgusting, but some of these bikinis they wear are so revealing that you might as well just go naked, seriously. Like it's not much different. But anyway, they get to ban the hijab because they don't like it. Well, that just shows how sense, and that just shows too their little feelings. They want to put their little feelings above just basic rights. I mean, they have liberty of conscience. They can wear it if they want, and plus, some of them choose to wear it. I mean, what if they choose to wear it? So because one of their arguments is that, oh, it's oppressing them. Well, what if they choose to wear it? So wait a second, they can't choose to wear it. Hey, whatever happened to my body, my choice? You little hypocrites. Seriously, what a bunch of little hypocrites. My body, my choice when it comes to killing your own child at the abortion mill. But it's not your body or choice when you wanted to dress modestly and wear a hijab. Am I a Mu No, I'm not a Muslim. I'm a Christian. But you see, my Baptist ancestors stood for liberty of conscience, and that includes the Muslim woman right to wear the hijab. That's just blunt and brutal. And not to mention, too, the reason why I'm against the stupid law is because if I was in Quebec, it would ban me from wearing a cross to work. Well, guess what? If this law comes here in Ontario, guess what? I'll be wearing a cross to work any day. Anyway. I don't care. I'm not going to follow their stupid law. I mean, seriously, a cross necklace is somehow bad. If this law passes in Ontario, I'll be wearing a cross necklace whether they like it or not. They don't like it, that's too bad. They can deal with it because it's freedom of speech, freedom of expression. That simple. And it's just blatantly hypocritical how my body, my choice when it comes to just murdering your own child at the abortion mill after a night out fornicating and playing the whore. But then it's not your body or choice when you want to wear the cross, when you want to just not take the vaccine, when you want to just wear the hijab. It's a bunch of hypocritical devils. That's all that it is. It's a bunch of hypocrites who are just double-minded, who just basically want to enforce their ideology. Like, they'll say, well, Muslims are forcing their ideology on Muslim women. Well, you're forcing your secular ideology on them. No, like, you're no different, seriously. And I guarantee you, this is going to make some people upset, but if a push comes to shove, and it comes down to the point where they're just violating my rights, you better bet I'll be picking up a rifle and fighting them, okay? And likewise, all my supporters, my Christian supporters, if push comes to shove, I'll even say this, even if they ban Islam in Canada, even if they just outright ban Islam, if the violation of liberty of conscience, and my Christian friends and I, we'll be putting down our mics, putting down our cameras, and picking up our rifles and fighting. We'll fight them, seriously. I mean, because they don't just get to violate our rights. and just get away with it. So just a bunch of hypocrites, double-minded little hypocrites they are, which, you know, is to be expected from these militant atheists, because when I was an atheist, I was a hypocrite too, and just hypocrisy and atheism just go hand in hand. Let's just face reality. Let's just be blunt and brutal about it. So anyway, don't be deceived, and don't be fooled. This is just a bunch of garbage going on over in Quebec. So anyway, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with all the brethren. Goodbye.